Welcome to part 3 of the Atavism X combat tutorial series. In this video, we'll be covering the effects plugin, but if you are new to Atavism, I recommend you follow along the entire series because of the way that all of the combat plugins work together in Atavism. Let's get started. The effects plugin in Atavism is used to decide what abilities do and to apply things to targets that affect their character's stats and values, such as dealing damage or applying buffs and debuffs. There is a wide range of effects available to you in the Atavism plugin, as you would expect in an MMORPG, that will allow you to create a plethora of abilities in your game. In this video, we will be continuing the creation of our unarmed strike ability, but we'll go over many of the other applications this effect plugin has. Start by opening up your Atavism X editor and selecting your profile, then opening up the combat tab and selecting the effects plugin. Here you should see quite a few examples of effects from the demo that you can use as references when making your effects in the future, but for now, we'll create one from scratch. So start by hitting the plus button in the bottom right corner. Now right away, you'll notice that compared to skills and ability plugins, there isn't a lot here initially. This is because most of the parameters will appear once we select what type of effect we need. For naming, it's good to keep it in line with your ability's name, but in many cases, the effect name will not be seen by the player, like in a case of our melee auto attack. But for instance, with buffs and debuffs and casting spells, it will be seen if the player's mouse over it, so we will name it Unarmed Strike. Then for the icon parameter, we will press Choose File to open the file browser. This should show us all icons in our Unity project if our editor is properly set up. Remember, if the icons are not showing up, to press the Synchronize button in the top right. For our effect, the icon really doesn't matter because the players will never see it, but try to match it to whatever icon you use on the ability, just in case. Now here, we'll look at the effect types. This is what will make the parameters appear for our effect, and there are a lot to choose from. Right away, you can guess that for our unarmed strike ability, we want the damage effect type. So when we select it, we'll see all of the parameters we need for that. But let's briefly go over what all of the other effect types can be used for. Restore is used to recover a vitality stat of your choosing. This would be used for mana potions, for healing spells, or for stamina recovery abilities, etc. The revive effect is used to bring dead targets back to life. The stat effect is generally what you would use for buffs and debuffs that affect stats, a spell that can increase movement speed by 5% or reduce casting speed or improve mana regeneration or attack power, stuff like that. A stun effect will be an effect that stops the player from moving or taking actions for its duration. Sleep is similar, but it will break when damage is taken. Immune effect is just basically immunity. It's pretty straightforward. You will not take any damage when this effect is on you. Morphing is used to morph a target into another form, changing the character model, the action bar, and even the movement type. So if you have shape-shifting in your game, this is what you would use. The dispel effect is used for removing debuffs and buffs, which you can categorize into types like magic, poison, and curse. The teleport effect can be used to teleport the caster to a specific location somewhere in the world or something they are targeting. The mount effect is used to bring a mount out for your player to ride on when they use an item or an ability. The build object effect is used for construction in your game. The teach ability and teach skill are what you would use if you plan on letting players learn skills from skill books. The task effect is used to complete tasks for quests, if you'd like an ability being used to complete a quest or an item or something like that. The state effect applies certain player states to a target, such as an underwater state. The threat effect will apply additional threat to targets without dealing damage by itself. Usually stuff like taunt abilities would use this. And then the create item effect, this is what you would use in things like forging or crafting items together. And the next one, create item from loot, lets you assign loot tables to the effect. You could use this for something like a goodie bag or a loot box where the players get something random from opening it from the table that you decide. The spawn effect will create a monster from using an ability. It can be a fighting pet, a non-fighting pet, or just a wild monster that attacks randomly if you want your players to summon bosses. Set respawn location would be akin to something like setting a hearthstone for an effect. VIP would be used with your cash shop rewards or other sort of special statuses that your players can earn. Then bonus effects are also generally tied to unique buffs that usually come with special rewards as well, such as experience bonuses or XP loss protection or higher loot drop rates, etc. Next is trap effects, which are used to create a trap on the ground that can be triggered both by friendly or enemy targets, depending on what sort of trap you want to create. For example, a bear trap to deal damage or a healing circle that will heal allies when they step on it. The stealth effect will handle the stealth mechanics in your game, making characters harder to spot using Atavism's stealth system. And a trigger effect is used with the effect's trigger profile, which you can see on the left side, which is a separate plugin. These will be things like on dodging or when you parry or when you take damage under certain conditions. Think of them a bit like procs in other MMORPGs. And then lastly, the shield effect, damage absorbing shields that go on top of your vitality stats. So that's a lot of effect options. We won't be covering how to use all of them in this video, but we'll use a few of them in the last video of this series. Most of the effects are very self-explanatory and very straightforward, as we'll see when we create our abilities. So let's move on back up to the damage effect type. For this effect type, we need to choose a subtype. We have the option of magic, physical damage effects, or apply a damage over time, or deal flat damage, which is something akin to like true damage. For our unarmed strike, we need melee strike effect because we're just punching somebody. Next, we'll select the vitality stat that will be affected, which is health in our case. We want to deal damage to the enemy target's health, and we can then choose the damage type. The damage type will determine what resistance are checked when the damage is applied. We are punching people, so we'll select crushing damage. Something like bludgeoning would work fine for this as well. The damage amount that you select here is the base damage of the effect before any multipliers are applied. The damage modifier beside it is the first multiplier you can use, but for the ease of calculations and starting out, we'll just use 100 damage with a modifier of 1. The transfer rate parameter over here allows us to force damage back to the caster as well. We can set it to 100% of the damage we deal dealt back to us or less, but in our case, we don't want to have any sort of double-edged sword with our attack. We don't want to take any damage when we punch somebody, so we will just leave this empty. The next field though, bonus damage effect requirements, lets us check for certain effects on the target, and if it's present, we can decide that this effect will do extra damage. This is something you'd use if you are setting up combo abilities in your game, but for an auto attack like ours, we can leave this empty. The pulse coordinated effect will allow us to call on the coordinated effects plugin to play animations and particles when this effect happens. There are some cases where you need to call on it from the effects plugin, but for the most part, we can call on the coordinated effects plugin using the abilities plugin instead, which is what we will be doing with this effect. So we'll leave it blank, and we'll be going over the coordinated effects plugin in the next video. The next parameter, skill type, lets us choose the skill this effect is going to use. In our case, it's using the unarmed strength skill, and then we can choose a modifier based on the level of this skill. This is important if you want the effect or ability to deal more damage based on the level of the skill. In our case, we do. We want our auto attack to do more damage the higher level our unarmed strength skill gets. So we'll set the skill modifier to 1. This will multiply the damage by 1 of our skill's level. Next is the tooltip. In the case of our instant hit ability, we do not need a tooltip here, but if you are creating a debuff or a buff or something that the player will see, you will definitely want to fill it out in case they mouse over it, to give them more information about what that effect is doing. The effect tag is used to call on the effect from other plugins such as the effects trigger profile plugin, but we can leave it blank for our unarmed strike ability. And then lastly, at the bottom, we have 4 fields that cover combo-like effects. We can check if an effect is present on the target, and if it is, apply an extra effect and decide if the old or new effect gets removed in the process. We don't need something like this for our simple unarmed strike effect, but you can get an idea of just how capable and flexible Atavism's effects plugin is in helping you to bring to life whatever effect you can imagine. But now that we have our effect completely filled out, we are almost ready to actually start punching stuff in game. So let's finish up the final steps. Make sure you hit the save button to save the effect, then navigate to your abilities plugin on the left side of your editor, and find our unarmed strike ability that we created in the last video. Open up the ability by double-clicking on it and scroll down to the effects. type in the name of our effect to find it, unarmed strike, and then select it. Then press the update ability button to save our changes. Now just to be sure, make sure you have this ability set as your player character warrior class's default auto attack ability. You can double check that this is set by going to the character tab on the left side, then double clicking on human warrior, and then check to see that the auto attack parameter is set to unarmed strike. What this means is from now on, anytime we auto attack and we have no weapon equipped, we're going to be using this punching ability to deal damage. Now we are basically all set to start punching stuff with our new ability. All we need to do is restart the server. If you're using the cloud server, you can do that by clicking the restart button on the green icons on the top right of the editor. Otherwise, be sure to restart your server appropriately based on how you are hosting it. Once the server restarts, you can open up your Unity project, log into the game, and we should still have our unarmed strength skill in our skill sheet. But the ability shouldn't show up because it's our auto attack and we didn't assign it to the skill. That doesn't mean it's not there, we just can't see it. So let's go find a monster that we can punch. There's some beetles down here. Now all we have to do is walk up and right click them, and we should start hitting them with our unarmed strike ability and dealing the effects damage, which isn't very much. And when we stop and look at our unarmed strength skill, you'll see that every time we attack, we get one experience. It looks like everything is working so far, but no one would ever play a game where the character punches without doing any sort of animation or effects or sounds, right? This punch is lacking its oomph. We need an animation, some effects, and some sound. That is where the last plugin comes in, coordinated effects. So we'll be jumping into that in the fourth part of this combat tutorial series. If you have any questions or difficulties with anything so far, don't be shy by hopping over to the Atavism Discord and asking for help from the passionate staff or the many helpful fellow Atavism developers that are hanging out there. I'll see you guys all in the next video. Don't forget to subscribe to the Atavism YouTube channel and hit the notification bell to be alerted when new videos on Atavism are released. Have a great day and happy developing.